So it just turns itself off then, huh? It's kind of lame. first moved out here, I didn't even want all these fucking dishes. I was like, I only need two plates, two spoons, two forks, you know, two of everything. Between my ex-girlfriend and a bunch of other people. This knife is fucked up. Yeah, So there's a bike back there. It's because I ride bikes everywhere. I don't ride a car. Because that whole Kantian notion of the categorical imperative contradictions and conceptions does say everybody can't have a car. If you gave everybody a car, nobody would get anywhere. So the roads would be clogged. If everybody used a car to go everywhere that they wanted to go, then no one would be able to go anywhere in a car. Fucking walking would be faster, or riding a bike. See, riding a bike is universal. Everybody can ride a bike. It'd actually be better for the planet, I think. Probably. Oh, fuck. I'm so exhausted. I think I might just hit the hay early today. Go to 7-Eleven, maybe buy me some fucking kick snacks or something. Oh, I gotta get water. Okay, yeah, you can. Let's get ready to go. Now this right here, still disgusting. Look at that. Good gravy, man. Fucking dirty cook. I mean, it's not as bad as it was, though. It's almost been 24 hours since my last drink. It's been, let's see, I want to sleep at like midnight, I want to say, or 1 or 2 maybe at the latest. Yeah. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. Yeah, so I should be coming out of that beer thing. I'm not getting hot flashes anymore. These things aren't even supposed to be all text. I've got the one with the data plan, and I just went and downloaded the app that does that, and I'm not going to say which one because I don't want to get crowded with people. Service already sucks enough. Missed the whole day. Luckily, lightning was canceled. Spent all day cleaning so far. And I woke up at what, 3:50? Fuck, I was sitting in bed all goddamn day. 3 hours, I got the whole place cleaned. Knock out. Mistake of going on to Reddit.
That's too bad. All right.
What we are about to embark on is the daily journey for water. Yes, I have to go get my own water. Like I was saying earlier about Lubbock tap water being cheap. I mean, it tastes funny to me. I mean, it may not actually be bad. I just don't like the taste. So yeah, you can chalk it up to a subjective matter of taste. Maybe the water's not crappy. I mean, people live off of it, obviously. And you see that, what I just did there, how I just disagreed with myself after saying something. I made a comment, and I was like, oh, you know what, that's not true because of this, this, and that. Part of the reason why I drink. Because when I drink, there's no disagreement. It's just, yeah. But maybe I am holding myself back, you know. I read this excellent poem the other day, and it said this line that really shocked me. The Wild Iris by Louis Gluck, or Louis Gluck. I don't know how to pronounce that. Somewhere around here on page 15, there's this one called A Retreating Wind. And now, I could be interpreting this wrong, but tell me this doesn't sound like God speaking to the humans, particularly the ones after the fall. Think also of the Garden of Eden. Think of the apple. And tell me if you get those things out of this. When I made you, I loved you. Now I pity you. I gave you all you needed. Bed of earth, blanket of blue air. And as I get further away from you, I see you more clearly. Your soul should have been immense by now. Not what they are. Small, talking things. I gave you every gift. Blue of the spring morning. Time you didn't know how to use. You wanted more. The one gift I reserved for another creation. Whatever you hoped, you will not find yourselves in the garden, among the growing plants. Your lives are not circular like theirs. Your lives are the bird's flight, which begins and ends in stillness, which begins and ends in form echoing. This arc from the white birch to the apple tree. Good imagery, huh? You can see the birds sitting by. I felt like it was about us. I felt like it was the voice of God almost when I first read it. It actually deeply troubled me the first time I read it, especially the line where he says, your soul should have been immense by now, not what they are, small talking things. And, you know, I just sat back and I thought about that, and I thought about, like, me and my drinking and what I'm accomplishing and what I'm doing with my life. It's like, I wasn't doing shit, dude. Like, nonstop. It wasn't a life worth living. And that's how that poem touched me, you know? It was just like, your soul should have been immense by now. And I think, yes, I think my soul could have been a lot more awesome by now. But I'm holding myself back with these, you know, these superficial entertaining things, the drinking, the watching the Hulu, the little kitten gifs. If you don't know what a gif is, it's just a little picture. It's on loop, and it's like a little cat, you know. It's like meow, playing with a laser, and then we'll just go back and forth for the rest of eternity, one would think. But, you know, yeah, small talking things. What does that mean? I mean, I'm a talking thing. I feel small, too, sometimes. I feel small, especially because, like, nobody else would be hearing this. If it weren't for me fucking recording this shit right now, nobody would give a fuck. I haven't got a call all day, in case you haven't noticed. I haven't had an email or a ring, you know, to say, hey, how are you doing? Oh, yeah, another thing. So you can know when I get calls. If you hear ching-ching like it's a bike, that's me getting a text message. If you hear dong, that's school. That's my Texas Tech account. And it's every time I hear that noise, it's just like, what's up now? It's very nerve-wracking at this point. It's my third year in, and it's hard. It's very fucking hard, man. They said it would be easier when you got to the end, because you'd be doing what you want to do. Yes, I am doing what I want to do, but things have gotten so particular. Like, I used to get 98 straight A's, now I'm getting B's and C's and D's. I got a 50 the other day in logic, but you know what? Fuck logic. I said that. Fuck logic. The logical forms of, like, A, therefore, they, then, B, and whatever, or, like, little logical proofs, those things say nothing about the actual argument. Because A could stand for apples are red. B could stand for sometimes if they're in this other place, they're green, you know? If they're in Washington, then they're red. If they're, I don't know where the fuck they make green apples, but you get the idea. And whenever you get all this logic stuff, like the A and then the B and then all the shit in between. Where is it? Hold on. Oh, yeah, here's some. Oh, it's fucking awesome. Oh, let's see. It is true if and only if at least one of the objects satisfies SX. It is true if and only if every object satisfies SX. All P's are Q's. Some P's are Q's. No P's are Q's. And then you go, and you can say, like, all cats are mammals. That's how it works, right? The cats are mammals, right? All P's are Q's, all cats are mammals. All cats are mammals. Wrangler or something. Dude, teacher didn't show up either, man. All my teachers bailed out today. We're all like, cubex. There exists something that is a cube. It's like, really? My friend tells me that the meaning for logic is that it gives you a set of rules and a world to work those rules in, and having the skill of being able to look at a set of rules and to follow those rules and to come to the correct conclusions given those rules is valuable in and of itself. It's like an intrinsic value for your mind to be able to do that, I guess. But I got to thinking, I'm like, that's like every fucking video game ever made. Pac-Man, Donkey Kong, Mario. They're all little world preset defined rules and shit. Not too different than logic. I mean, only logic's a lot less entertaining. I take that back. Some people are probably entertained as fuck by logic. I kind of like the idea of calling myself a logician, but fuck that. Waste of time. Oh yeah, water trip. We gotta go get water. Trying to get it closed, because kiss, it just doesn't ever work. Junk starts collecting.
You see how the junk is starting to collect and accumulate already? It's like, fuck, man.
Okay. I'm sure. Hurry up.
This is the multi-tool. Never go anywhere without your trusty multi-tool. Because if you go somewhere without this trusty multi-tool and you run into a problem, a predicament, there's a chance you could have solved it. Pretty damn good one, as a matter of fact.
I've run into so many situations where I was like, oh, I wish I had my multi-tool. And then sure enough, oh, I did bring my multi-tool. Use the multi-tool, profit. Use it for fixing doors, fixing hinges, fixing things that are bent, don't need to be bent. Use it as a wedge. You'd be surprised. I've used it as a wedge a lot of times. That it, you need wedges. It's weird to say that, but you just fucking do. Everybody needs a wedge. Alright.
For the trip. I'm gonna go get some water.
Trusty multi-tool. Do this. Once again, the old adage of survival, man, holds true. Never go anywhere without a trusty multi-tool.
That should be recording in there.
Let's get some more.
and stop recording. Green piles up. In the spirit of utopia, I got some tang. I mean, I've had it, but I saw red with it the one day, and I was like, fuck,